Evans is working both behind and in front of the camera with Before We Go. For his directorial debut, he took his considerable clout and fame and made a movie that couldn't possibly be more different from the spectacles that have been his bread and butter. It is an indie romance in which he tries to rescue one person from a terrible night rather than the entire planet for all of eternity. And there are no special effects to be found. In fact, every moment here is special, including the individual charms of Evans and Alice. These photogenic and charismatic actors somehow manage to conjure sparking chemistry with each other because they are even looking at each other in characters in a flimsy and love-struck manner. Let's assume they are high on acting skills, okay? The fact that it's premise of two strangers walking and talking all night calls to mind superior films, mainly Before Sunrise, only makes things smooth. In this movie, though the characters are so vapid and there is so little at stake, it's impossible to care about what happens to them from one moment to the next, much less the outcome of an entire night in New York. The city does look lovely. Evans knew well enough to learn from people in other departments and let them do what they do best. The cinematographer, John, makes Manhattan glitter and shimmer in all the most romantic ways, but there is much more chemistry inside that promised packaging. When we first see Evans' character, Nick, it's from afar in Grand Central Terminal, where he is playing his trumpet for loose change late at night. As the busy train station is winding to a close, a beautiful blonde comes dashing past him, dropping her cell phone on the ground and breaking it in her haste. She's Eve's Brooke, and she's just missed the 1:30 a.m. train to New Haven. When the gentlemanly Nick catches up to her and tries to help her get home, she's rude and dismissive, even though her purse has been stolen and she's now without a phone as well. Inconveniences like this conveniently keep piling up throughout the course of the night to keep these two together, like denied credit cards, a dying cell phone battery, and not enough cash for a cab or a bus. So do random side trips as they try to scrounge up some money to old friends, bars, a psychic, and a hotel party, where they pretend to be the musical act with a stripped-down rendition of My Funny Valentine. Through it all, they stroll leisurely throughout various downtown neighborhoods, telling their stories about career choices and lost love, and eventually sharing their secrets and fears. She's a refined, married art dealer whose future hinges on returning to her house by morning, while he is a self-deprecating, broken-hearted jazz musician with a big audition in the morning. Some of it is very compelling, heavy platitudes like, "Sometimes you have to just make the choice and jump," only highlight how substantial these characters are. I would like to rate this movie 8 out of 10 this time because of the simplicity and the focus. Maybe this movie is your next bet for this Valentine's month. So friends, that's all for today. See you around.